Welcome to the Best Coast Shire Council Report, your weekly update on council news and events.
Hi, I'm Lauren Grills.
And I'm Steve Fury.
Welcome to this week's show, where we'll be talking about the latest edition of Coastell, an upcoming Future Homes event, and a reminder for those interested in standing for council. But first, an update on the land subject to inundation overlay, that's Amendment C82.
It might be a bit of a mouthful, but the Minister for Planning has finally approved Amendment C82, also known as the Land Subject to Inundation Overlay, or LSIO, which is flooding for you and me, with the new controls now forming part of the Bass Coast planning scheme. Now, the amendment has been a joint project between Council, Melbourne Water and the West Gippsland Catchment Management Authority, and approval by the Minister is a major step forward in a long-term planning for areas that are at risk of riverine and coastal flooding.
So what is the LSIO exactly? This amendment introduces new planning permit requirements for earthworks, buildings and works in areas identified at risk of flooding. This information will appear on planning and property information certificates and may also be used to help council and other agencies plan and prioritise emergency management and drainage management plans. It also means any affected areas can be identified and considered in the early stages of development process.
Council has welcomed the decision of the Minister, and which confirms Council's commitment to working with the community to secure a built environment that complements our landscape, lifestyle and climate.
If you'd like to find out more information about the adopted Amendment C82, you can visit our website at basscoast.vic.gov.au/LSIO.
If it hasn't already, Coastell will be hitting your mailbox very soon, and if you can't really bear to wait any longer, you can read it online now on Council's website. Stories this issue include an update on the Phillip Island Health and Medical Hub, details on the draft 2016-17 budget, some capital works projects that have been happening around the Shire, and much more.
You may notice on the front cover is a story about Coastell going electronic by the end of this year. This is not only due to the rising cost of postage, but also a proactive move to a more modern and environmentally sustainable format.
During our recent rate capping consultation sessions, our community actually said they wanted to see less printed publications and more options available online. And moving to a predominantly electronic newsletter will mean that we can make significant savings, both from a printing and postage costs. But to make this work, we need your help. So to make sure you continue to receive Coastell via email, please visit basscoast.vic.gov.au/Coastell. That's basscoast.vic.gov.au/COASTELL and sign up. It'll only take a few minutes, and you can also read the current issue online at this address.
Even though Council is moving to a more online-based distribution, this doesn't mean that residents and ratepayers won't be able to get a printed copy. We want everyone to be able to access Council's newsletter in the format that suits them best. So if you're not so computer savvy and wish to receive a printed copy of Coastell, please contact Council's Media Communications Officer, Simone Short, on 03 5671 2703. Paper copies will also be made available at Council's Customer Service Centres, Visitor Information Centres and from local libraries. Those who receive a large print or audio copy will still continue to receive these. Just a reminder, there won't be a spring edition of Coastell due to the caretaker period for the October Council elections.
Keeping with the online trend, Council is also now on Facebook, so whilst you wait for your Coastell newsletter, you can keep up to date with everything that's happening at Council at facebook.com/BassCoastShire. We're also on Twitter, just use our handle at BassCoast, that's all one word, and we provide news on what's happening at Council as well as information about events, emergency warnings and roadworks that might affect you.
Moving on, if you enjoy a day out in the garden, then our upcoming Future Homes workshop is one for you. This fun, social and informative day will be held at the Phillip Island Community Orchard, where you will learn about pruning and composting and have your questions answered by gardening experts. This is a free day and lunch will be provided.
Now, this event's happening on Saturday the 18th of June, and it's going to run from 10 a.m. until around 2 o'clock in the afternoon at the Community Orchard, which is on the corner of Hode Street and Hallway Drive in Wimbledon Heights. If you'd like to attend, you will need to RSVP to Rosie Scott Thompson at education@basscoastlandcare.org.au, or you can give her a call on 0409 366 914. Make sure you bring along your gardening gloves and dress for a day in the garden.
Finally, another reminder about the local government elections that are happening this year on the 22nd of October. Becoming a councillor is a great chance to influence the future direction of your local community. So if you're over 18 and on the electoral roll for the council area, then chances are you're eligible to stand. If you're thinking about running or even just a little bit interested in learning more, then head along to one of the Stand for Council events which are being held in August. August?
The first session will be on Monday the 22nd of August at the Grantville Transactions Centre, then Tuesday the 23rd at the Cowes Cultural Centre, and the last session is in the Civic Centre Council Chamber in Wonthaggi on Thursday the 25th. All these sessions run from 7 to 9pm, and if you need more information, contact us on the numbers at the end of the show or visit the campaign website, standforcouncil.com.au.
And that's all we've got time for this week. As always, if you have any questions or need more information about anything we've mentioned, give us a call on 1300 B-Coast. That's 1300 226 278 or 03 5671 2211. And keep up to date on our Facebook page at facebook.com/Bass Coast Shire or follow us on Twitter on @BassCoast. Catch you next week for more council news.
The Bass Coast Shire Council Report is broadcast on Tuesday mornings at 9:30, Thursday afternoons at 4:30, and on Saturday mornings at 10 on your community station 3MFM. Audio and transcript is also available from our website, basscoast.vic.gov.au.